First of all, review what we learned last week. As you all know, we're doing a series entitled The Heart of Christ. And last week we talked about holiness and how the holiness of Christ should also be the same holiness that we strive for. Last week we learned that we should not be intimate with unbelievers. Because of the issue of ownership, who is the owner of our lives? And then second, the issue of residency, who lives in our hearts? Then third, the issue of one's state in life, are we righteous or are we lawless? And then the issue of representation, am I light or am I darkness? And then we also learn three principles for being holy. First, we said that there are areas in life where Satan has complete control, so we must have nothing to do with it. And then second, there are areas where we actually have in common with the world. And we don't need to abandon our faith, but to compromise the truth. And then thirdly, there are areas in life where only we as Christians are supposed to engage in. And that is praying, sharing the gospel, and making disciples. To begin today's message, I'd like to first of all share with you something that happened in October 23 of 1983. I don't know if you recall that on that particular date there was an event that happened in Lebanon. On that day, there were two trucks that were filled with bombs that sped into the compound of the U.S. Marines. And when they were able to enter into the compound, the drivers detonated the bomb, so they were actually suicide bombers.
So in the key,
and as a result, 241 American Marines were killed that day. And then 128 were seriously injured. And one of the wounded soldiers was named Corporal Jeffrey Lee Nashton. And he was severely wounded, and because of that, he was transported to the military hospital in Germany. And he had so many of these tubes attached to his body. Now one day, the Marine commandant named Paul Kelly visited the wounded soldiers in Germany. And as the commandant was coming near Corporal Nashman, the corporal struggled to find a piece of paper and a pen. And And then, in that piece of paper, he only wrote two words. And these two words are in Latin. And the words were Semper Fi.
Semper Fi.
This two words actually is the motto of the U.S. Marines.
Well, I share it in the Latin, but not just in the high point in it,
And the meaning of that phrase, Semper Fi, is always faithful or always loyal.
Semper Fi, is to say,
actually, this phrase is the shortened form of the word of the phrase Semper Fidelis.
So, in Chinese, this is the word of Semper Fidelis, the meaning is to say,
Even though he had suffered greatly because of the bombing, he let his commander know that he would remain faithful to his country and to his unit, the Marine Corps.
So he got the Australian important to think he just damn sure, that he I hope he is young John, the Azaya Sebong, he took on the chicken, young man, he was a big young ho, he got a big gun, he gave it, they shall chin down.
Now imagine if you were in the shoes of this soldier on that fateful day in 1983. And then you were sent to the hospital, tubes running to your body. Could you still say Semper Fi? Can you still pledge allegiance to your country and to your military unit, even though you have been injured? Now, maybe we don't need to use war as an illustration. But let's talk about marriage as an illustration. I saw the picture of this couple. They've been married for more than 60 years. You can see from the wedding picture, it's still in black and white. Now, just think through these questions, especially for the married people. Will you be faithful to your spouse even if they are the most unlovable person? Would you still be faithful to him even though he is very sick, lying in a bed and helpless? Would you still love him or her even though he is no longer physically attractive? Maybe before he has what is called as a six-pack abs. But now he carries a beer belly. So would you still love him? Would you still love your wife even though she's now considered in what we call in Tagalog as low shang? So will you be faithful to your spouse even if they change over the years? You know, many years ago there was this movie. It's a very controversial movie. And it starred Robert Redford, Woody Harrelson, and Demi Moore. And the title of the movie is Indecent Proposal. In this movie, Robert Redford is a billionaire.
And
he sees the wife of Woody Harrelson is attracted to her, and so he offers the character of Woody Harrelson $1 million so that he could sleep with his wife.
If one of them see Kwanzoi Woody Harrison, he had more maybe more, he had a chin sweet, so he don't eat the outfit, and eat him, Mamon, Harrison, they jump in board, they more joy in him, takes armor.
Now, the very strange thing about this film was that the husband accepted the offer. But then I find it rather strange because actually that's what happened, what's happening in reality also.
So people
nowadays can be unfaithful to their spouse for much worse than $1 million. So this morning we're talking about faithfulness, or the other word that we use is reliability. Now faithfulness is a topic that I'm sure that we have shared here in the pulpit many times. But unfortunately, it's one of those things that we don't practice very well. And so this morning, we're going to look at the faithfulness of Jesus Christ, and then we try to translate this to our everyday practice of
faithfulness.
Now, if you still remember our study of the book of Hebrews, you will recall that this book was written to the Jewish Christians to encourage them to hold on to the faith.
And so,
they were called be faithful, and then at the same time, there was the warning, don't go back to the old faith, because it's an inferior faith. Now, our passage this morning is actually about the superiority of Jesus Christ as compared to Moses. Now, for the Jews, Moses was someone that they held in high esteem. Why? Because he was the one who led the people of Israel out of Egypt. And then secondly, it was through Moses that the law was given to Israel. And then third, for the Jews, they consider Moses as being a faithful man of God. Although he was not a perfect man of God, because he has his shares of sins against God. And so the author of Hebrews, here in chapter 3, he began the section by talking not about the faithfulness of Moses, but he begins by talking about the faithfulness of Jesus Christ. In other words, he was saying, if Moses was called faithful by the people of Israel, then how much more the Lord Jesus Christ is faithful? But then what exactly was the faithfulness of Jesus Christ, or how was it manifested? Now the author of Hebrews describes it in three areas. And these three areas are actually models for us to also imitate. And so the very first way in which Christ was faithful was in his relationship to God. First of all, he is faithful over God's house as a son, according to verse 6.
In the 6th章讲, 就是教导上帝的儿子，把他以家做上帝儿子，在他中心做因老爸的工作。
Although Jesus came to earth, he served, he seek, he sought and saved the lost. But then remember, he also came as God's son.
虽然耶稣基督来到世上的时候，也来释放，来拯救失踪的人，但是伊后面也搁用心地去被无义的老虎。
And he showed his faithfulness to God first of all by strengthening his relationship with the Father.
头前伊个甲上帝真实伫遐真正活过的时阵，伊就是啊，强强刚强咯，强强提高伊甲上帝关系。
The Bible gives us a lot of examples of how the Lord Jesus prioritized his relationship with the Father.
最近真侪所在有记载讲，耶稣用什么方法可以甲天父伫遐的关系常常保持了真正刚强。
If you remember, at age 12, he went to the temple. And we know that he stayed behind in the temple area and he was talking, he was dialoguing with the religious teachers and leaders. And then when Joseph and Mary came back, and then when they found him, they questioned him and asked, why did you do this to us? And Jesus said, do you not know I must be at my Father's house? Here he was talking about the necessity for him to be in the presence of God.
意思就是表达讲，我就时常伫阮天父的内面来站立。
Then another example was when he was starting his ministry.
所以我提到这个例子，就是咱就看到讲，伊开始咧侍奉的时阵，
he would intentionally go out in the morning before dawn in order to spend time to pray.
所以天未光的时阵，真早的时阵就找时间出去。 去一个所在，伫遐甲上帝讲话，伫遐来祈祷。
Then another example would be after performing the miracle of multiplying the five loaves and two fishes, he sent his disciples to the other side, and then he spent some time to be with God.
圣经啊，记载讲，伊五个青年人食饱的时阵，伊五块饼两尾鱼，伊个船舵散会了的时阵，伊叫船舵先坐船，加东加海，然后伊家己伫迄个所在。
And then finally, we learn that prior to going to the cross, Jesus also sought the Lord in an extended time of prayer in the Garden of Gethsemane. You see, the Lord Jesus, he valued his relationship with God the Father.
保持伊甲上帝的关系。
And to be very involved in our relationship with the Father is an expression of our faithfulness towards Him.
甲上帝伫遐交通的中间，就是讲咱要伫遐真正用心交对。
And this is true for all of us. If you want to be faithful to God, you have to begin by valuing your relationship with Him.
所以你要甲上帝伫遐。
You know, very often when we talk about being faithful to God, we actually emphasize a lot on doing things for God. For example, I attend church services every Sunday without fail.
刚才咱的弟兄，我上小弟礼拜天唔捌着弟兄，确实哦，当天每礼拜我拢伫教会咧聚会。
I attend my Bible study every Wednesday night.
那到拜三呢，我每礼拜拜三也是咧参加查经班。
I am involved in a ministry every week.
我每礼拜拢伫教会有一项的事项。
Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying that doing things for the Lord is bad.
唔通听唔着，我嘛唔是说讲为主来侍奉是一项无好嘅事。
Because to do things for the Lord is an expression of faithfulness.
有影为主做工是一款嘅方便，表达你对主嘅忠心。
But it is not a substitute for our relationship with God.
但是这样不会作为代替咱甲上帝关系。
You see, to do things for the Lord is more like the outward manifestation of my relationship.
因为你了为主来做工是表达你外表的方便，讲你了为主爱表真重。
But the top priority is always the relationship.
但是最重要、最优先的呢，是你跟上帝的关系是什么关？
That should be over and above what we do.
这是超过一切咱所行所做的。
Let me give an example from marriage.
所以，你话不在于这个婚姻的态度来给咱辨别。
I'm sure that for many husbands, they will outright say that they love their families.
每一个丈夫，现在你问伊的时阵，伊的随时讲已经疼伊家庭。
And to show that love, he will prove it by working hard.
现在要表达讲伊疼伊家庭，已经肯做工。
Probably if he is employed, he will really work late into the night.
现在伊工作中间，伊做一到半暝。
Or if he owns a business, he will even bring home his work, and you know, don't disturb him while he's doing something in the study.
现在第二，所以星期的时阵，集中心，甚至将消防队过来出来，来出来第二来继续做伊的星期。
And he would do this every day.
但你若看到伊真正真用。
And his goal for doing it is so that, in his mind, he would say, I want to make sure I can provide for my family.
现在伊安尼做，伊心中伊思念就是说，讲伊往通予伊个家庭内面有够遐个供应。
I want to make sure that we have that nice house so that we can be all comfortable.
我将来要去 stay 住，予个人真正舒爽。
I want my kids to have neat stuff so that they don't feel as if they're inferior to their classmates.
我爱有囡仔有真正好个礼物，吼，赢得其他个同学。
I want my wife to have that new car so that she doesn't have to drive that old wreck of a car. All these are good. But then many times the wife and the kids begin to complain. And their complaint is this, they say,I feel neglected because my husband is always busy.
现在太太讲，我伫遐，咱像去不约去，因为阮丈夫想得无闲无倒来。
We no longer have any date night.
阮唔捌三甲伫遐有啥物约会。
And then the kids also complain that daddy has no time for me.
还有囡仔同款的是讲，阮爸爸讲我伊无时间通甲我约会。
We have no time to play sports.
阮无三甲出去佚佗。
We don't have time to do things together.
We have
no time to go out and have that extended vacation.
We
don't have time for family
devotions.
See the viewpoint of the husband and the wife and the kids.
也看到这个最重要的、最太太的、最兄弟，因无啥的观点啊。
For many husbands, their expression of love is, I will work hard so I can supply my family with what they need and want.
所以个丈夫讲到你，困最难，互我通伊来供应阮厝内一切需要。
But for the wife and kids, their idea of love is.I want my husband or I want my father to spend quality time with me.
做太太、做囡仔的时阵，伊个做太太爱讲，伊个丈夫常常甲伊提咧，伊个囡仔常常讲，伊老爸就伫厝内甲伊三合做代志。
And you know, I think God feels neglected too, just like a wife or children.
咱在有阵啊，上帝看咱个用心的时阵，其实咱也分别表到上帝最对。
We are too busy for God.
咱想得无闲，想将上帝放伫一个角落。
We do a lot of things for the Lord inside the church, but then we don't prioritize the relationship.
感恩咱伫教会中为主做了真侪工作，真正无闲，但是袂记哩表达上帝伫阿个亲密的关系。
We don't meet with Him each day in prayer.
咱特别袂记哩祈祷甲上帝伫阿来沟通。
We don't read the Word long enough to let it soak into our minds.
咱也无伫阿读伊个话语，互迄个话语真侪伫咱个思念中，进入咱个心腹中。
We don't spend enough time.To enjoy His presence. And so, our idea of spending time with God is probably taking up the daily bread, read it for a few minutes, close it, say a 30-second prayer, and then we're out of the house. So we have to be like Jesus because His first priority was His relationship with the Father.
So we have to have a relationship with the Father.
And so let us be faithful in maintaining and growing our relationship with God. Secondly,Christ is faithful as to His responsibility to God. Now the author of Hebrews lists for us the following responsibilities that Christ fulfilled and He is still continuing to fulfill. In verse 1 of chapter 3, Jesus is mentioned as being an apostle. Now, this is, I think, the only time that Jesus is actually referred to as an apostle.Now, our Lord Jesus is an apostle, not in the sense that we understand the word meaning the 12, no. But instead, it is in the sense that he is the one whom God has sent. He's the one sent to redeem us, to do the work of redemption, of salvation. And then, secondly, the Lord is also called the High Priest. In the Old Testament, the High Priest, he was responsible for making sacrifices and then he also interceded for the people.
So in the Old Testament, the high priest was for the people to intercede,
And we know that the Lord Jesus, He fulfilled His responsibility by sacrificing Himself once and for all for the sins of humanity.
所以你从闽南话就耶稣基督最大圣事，伊的超越的中心就是将伊本身最祭物献上给上帝。
And then as to his second responsibility to intercede for the people, we know that he continues to pray for us even as he is now in heaven.
第二方面，伊最大圣事就是为咱底下来求托，为咱底下来祈求天父底下通得着天父。所欢喜来完成上帝伊个心中所属的使命。
And then in verse 3, Jesus is described as being the builder of God's house.
但是咱要看第三节的时阵，第三章讲到耶稣基督遮形容讲，伊是个建造者。
In other words, he's the one who is continually building the church by adding new souls, new people into it.
因为耶稣继续伫啊中心伫啊来建造这个。
As you look at these responsibilities, we can safely say that no one among us can accuse the Lord of being negligent of his responsibilities.
So when I go to church, it's a watching board. When I'm not here, like when we go to Yasuo, we go to the church, 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 we go to the church.
Because if you look at our Lord Jesus, you will see that he completely fulfilled his duty, and there are some responsibilities that he still faithfully is doing on our behalf.
So in the
As an apostle, he fulfilled his duty when he went to the cross to die for us. Right now, as our high priest, he continues to pray for us. Then as the builder of the house, he still is adding new people into the church every day. And he's still equipping more people so that they can participate in the work. In Philippians 1:6, it records that God has begun a good work in us and he will bring it to completion.
You
know, God is not going to abandon us, but he will finish the work that he has started. He will see to it that we will be made perfect. Christ Jesus. And so from these three responsibilities that Christ fulfilled, we find three things that we should be diligent in doing. First of all, we must be proclaiming the gospel as an apostle, in the sense that God has sent us out also to share. Second, we must continually pray for others because we are God's holy priesthood and we should be interceding for one
another.
And finally, we must be building and equipping God's people through ministry and discipleship. Now, aside from these three things that Christ did, there are other responsibilities listed in the Bible that we should also be diligent in fulfilling. If you are a parent, okay, or if you are parents, it is your responsibility to take care of your families. You have to assume the responsibility of doing good to other people. You have to be a good citizen of your country. You have to be salt and light in this dark world. Now that's just to name a few. There are many more. And then God has also given us these various responsibilities that only we can fulfill. And he has equipped us with spiritual gifts, talents, and skills, as well as sometimes the material resources. Now, God is not expecting that we have to be involved in everything. Because if you join everything, you're not going to accomplish anything at all. You see, if you take on too much responsibility, you will be haphazard. And then you also burn yourself up. Instead, what the Lord is expecting of us is that we prioritize our lives as to our responsibilities. And so the primary things that we should be doing, this is listed on the screen. And then certain responsibilities that we have to do because like we have our families, okay, our witness. And when we do these things well for the Lord, we actually show our faithfulness to Him. And then finally, Christ is faithful when He showed accountability to God. Although it's not very pronounced in the passage, take note that the Lord was described as being faithful to the one who appointed
him.
And to be faithful requires that we be accountable.
So if we are to be
before our Lord was tried and crucified, he spent some time in prayer in the Mount of Olives or the Garden of
Gethsemane.
And the Apostle John recorded this prayer in his Gospel account. Now, the Lord prayed, it wasn't just about himself or about his disciples. But in his prayer, he was also giving a summary of what he was able to accomplish for the Father. Now, this is not about bragging, but it was about accountability, giving a report. But then what exactly did the Lord Jesus report to the Father? First of all, we find in John 17 that He first manifested God's name to the people. What it means is that He has revealed the Father to those whom God has given Him, the disciples. And then the second thing was that He reported that He has prayed for His people, for the disciples, as well as for those who will believe in the future. And then third, He gave the glory that He enjoyed with God to His people. And what it simply means is that the glory of being close with the Father, He now gives to His disciples so that they can also be close to the Father in relationship.
所以这你叫上帝看底下，为着上帝来应邀上帝代志，应种这项代志，一定我一摆转好转门道，我转门道伫伊个生活中，我通应邀上帝，这个就底下保护底下来托付的工作，来向上帝来交代。
So what lesson can you learn about Christ here in John 17?
所以你要看从十七章，你读学到什么功课呢？
I think it's simply this, we are accountable to God for how we live our lives.
意思说，咱每一位在上帝面头前，咱拢着了有报告，咱着去交效，是讲咱是不是忠心，在咱的生活中活出上帝爱咱活的生活。
We are accountable for our service to Him.
咱是奉主意着向上帝来交托。
We're accountable for the maintenance and the growth of our relationship.
咱好好做个工作，啊，伫上帝所托付咱个，咱着伫遐来记录、来报告，互上帝知影。
And because we have this accountability to God, we should be careful not to be negligent about this.
因为咱着伫遐高效，所以咱着真正注意，伫咱一举一动个中间，着好好伫遐来做。
We have to see to it that whatever God has entrusted to us, we accomplish.
你上帝托付咱着做，咱着完全着完成伊所交付咱的。
Now, if you notice, Jesus, he told a lot of parables.
咱着知影，主耶稣已经做披露。
Last month, I talked about the parable of the talents.
咱着讲伫遐，你着栽培的一个披露。
And then there's the parable of the shrewd manager.
啊，讲一个啊。无良善的主人哦，管家的故事。
And then there's the parable of the ten minas.
十对轮，十两轮的这个故事，也是耶稣的比喻。
All these parables are actually about accountability.
所以两种的比喻其实是讲，叫咱在底下好好有交托、有交代。
And so when we realize that we are accountable to God, then we should be moving towards faithfulness and not.
所以为了咱知影讲，一日咱着交代互上帝，伊所托付咱个工作个时阵，咱唔通在底下真正随便吼，伫搭方面继续用心交代。
But then, how does God hold us accountable?
上帝要怎样底下吾咱来互效呢
？First of all, He holds us accountable to the standard that He has set forth in the Word.
头先伊个吾咱个要求是讲，伊咱是是照伊个话语个标准底下来行事。
The Word of God is perfect, and it is our guide for holiness and righteousness.
所以上帝的话语就是神的话，才是咱的标准，咱就用迄个来底下啊尊重上帝话语，来尊敬主的话。
We must always compare ourselves, what we do, our relationship with God, against what the Bible is saying.
所以，伫咱生命中，咱所行所做，常常用圣经来做标准，是毋是咱有遵照上帝所托付咱的，有好好来交代。
And so, I hope that we don't compare ourselves with others.
唔嘛，咱毋是叫别人伫遐来比较。
Because when we compare ourselves with others, then we have a faulty standard.
因为咱用别人来做标准的时阵，安尼唔对。
But when we compare ourselves against the perfect Word of God, then we have this image that we have to conform to.
所以，咱人用上帝的话语，伊才是完全的标准。咱就底下能得到一个正直，底下得到一个圣洁的生活。
Secondly, He holds us accountable to our brothers and sisters in the church.
然后，接着咱伫教会中间兄弟姊妹有三个底下有交代。
You know, God has provided us with people here in church whom we call as brothers and sisters.
所以上帝比咱咱伫教会中，咱就做着是咱的阿姊，是咱的小弟，是咱的兄弟。
Now, calling people your brothers and sisters here in church is not just a formality. It's not just a title.
所以啊，称呼人是兄弟姊妹中间，唔是只有一个啊称呼人的名词而已。
But God has provided these people so that we can go to them, to ask them to help us, to ask them to check us, to keep us in check.
但是反倒等伫家庭内的时阵，在咱的长辈、咱的兄弟，咱就伫遐来将咱的问题啊，伫遐来问应，还是伫遐来 找因的辅导，强在因底下啊，有阵啊会食济人，较袂咱做低头。
We are to be accountable to each other by checking on how we are doing spiritually.
咱就互相彼此底下来啊，三甲来有交代啊，三甲来看咱家己吼有一个标准。
You know, sometimes it's very encouraging when someone asks you the question, "What did you learn from your quiet time?"
刚才真正开始，我阵啊，人忽然间问人讲，你安静的时间现在什么款式？
Because when someone asks you that question, and you know that they will ask you again and again, it sort of makes you want to pay attention to your quiet time.
刚才常常人咧问你这个问题的时阵，所以刚才你会更加注意哦，你会对家庭、对你人生的生活，有人伫啊咧啊发动你的时阵，你会更加尽量来行来做。
Or sometimes the issue of doing ministry, someone may ask you, "How is your service?" or "How is your ministry?"
刚才伫你侍奉中间，有阵啊人会问讲，你现在会侍奉什么款的时阵？安尼的时阵，我一摆。
Or probably when we have struggles that we're facing in life.
刚才你有拄着生命中一个会挑战的时阵呢？
And so, let me say this: don't be ashamed to tell them about what's really going on in your life.
唔通搁遐哦，真正歹势，但是蛮多等真大胆会甲因讲，你现在处境如何？
You know, very often we as Chinese were very shy to let people know.The real situation in our lives.
咱做中国人诶哦，常常真正害羞，真正变小哦，唔爱将咱诶私事甲人讲。
Like sometimes someone may ask us, "Kumusta ka na? How are you?"
咱做阵啊，咱会听着讲 "Kumusta ka na?" 哦，你现在怎样
？And our immediate answer is, "Okay lang."
那问你讲食咩好食啦？哈，食了未
？That's we're trying to hide ourselves.From other people. But don't you think that sharing with people we trust the struggles that we're going through in a way will help us in the end?
但是咱我通找主来来临，将咱的代志会做做啊，会靠一个人，咱来做来讲吼，不如咱拄着问题、难题时阵，咱三个来分担。
Or sometimes maybe when we need advice on certain things.We can approach people and ask them, "Can you help me understand what to do with this situation?"
刚才你遇到一个难题的时阵，你唔知影怎么处理的时阵，你会做请教，你会咱下底姊妹讲，我遇到这样代志，是不是最好会解决呢
？And so accountability is very important in our relationship with God.
有人伫遐咧监察咱哦，互咱有通一个交代，这个是真正重要。
Because when There is someone who keeps us in check. When there is a standard that keeps us in check, the result is that we will pursue faithfulness.
那有人伫遐咧禁止咱，那是互咱伫遐哦，接着上帝话语最用心来伫遐教导咱，互咱伫各项方面有一个叫会标准的时阵，安尼咱各伫遐通得到一个更加用心的生活。
So all of us, we are called to be faithful or reliable to the Lord.
所以每一个人，每一个基督徒，伫耶稣基督内面，咱应该着伫遐忠心，意思讲咱着伫遐有责任。
We have to be faithful in maintaining and strengthening our relationship with Him.
所以咱搁伫遐，互相着通伫遐来祷告咱，咱搁较着伫上帝甲咱的关系中，继续伫遐来建造、来建立。
We have to be faithful in doing our responsibilities to Him.
用心地上帝所托付咱的工作中。
And then, thirdly, we are to be faithful by showing our accountability to Him.
所以地上帝面头前，咱也着将上帝所交托咱的好好了有交代，来报告互伊知影咱的现实。
Now I believe that all of us we fall short in one area, or probably even in all the areas of faithfulness.
现在当然真侪人哦，有一方面，现在咱底下有较，或者是讲三方面，咱都做无够。
I hope that later on in the day you will take time to evaluate yourself.
现在你耍了没时间的中间，今仔日好好底下来看咱家己。
Ask yourself, am I faithful in my relationship with you?
我甲主的关系中间是毋是伫遐有真正诚恳、有真诚来做
？Am I faithful in my responsibilities to Him？
上帝所交托我的责任的方面，我是不是尽量
？And am I faithful in showing my accountability to them？
在上帝面头前，我唔是是唔是伫遐常常来报告，让上帝知影，伫遐来高效
？But then I don't want you to just end there。
我嘛唔是就停止这方面。
But I also want you to make some steps, necessary steps in your life, so that you can become faithful to the Lord。
所以，感谢是真侪方面，你无继续伫遐来做吼，唔忘你支持到尾尽量。
Let's pray。
阿头先的部分。
Father, we thank you for the timely reminder from your word that we are to be faithful or reliable to you. Lord, we know that we fail very often to be faithful to you, that we neglect you, we neglect our responsibilities, and we do not give a very good accounting of our life to you. Father, we pray that as we will take time to evaluate and to just think through our life, our relationship with you, may you awaken our hearts, Lord, that we will desire to be faithful to you, and may we find practical steps by which we can express our faithfulness. Father, thank you, and we commit ourselves once again to you. In Jesus' name.